Hello, I'm Alan and welcome to Enots Engineering. In this video we'll be making two components for the radius cutter. The first is a new setting piece with the flat in the middle so the tooltip can come straight down to the middle for setting, and the second is an offset tip holder which will bring the tip closer to the setting piece. So let's go into the workshop, see how we make them. So this is the radius cutter and that's my setting pin. If you've watched the other video you'll know that that is a 6mm radius, so that pin is 12mm. And it fits in an 8mm dowel in the centre of the radius cutter. So what I need to do to get smaller than a 6mm radius, make it so that I can mill a flat on here halfway down the diameter in the centre line and be able to put the tip of the tool to that flat so I can go down to zero. And then with the flat on I could use
gauge block
or a vernier to give me a measurement from the actual centre line to the tip.
Just over 0.315. I'm setting the parting off tool square using the square up against the part I've just made.
Selected the tool holder with a V in the base. I've mounted the bar in the tool holder. Next job is to clock this up true the tool holder. Then I'll put a milling cutter in there and mill the end of the bar. It's about 3/10 over 2 inches. Some steel in the four-jaw chuck. I've changed the dial indicator to one that will give me at least a 3mm reading. Zero there. 10, 20, 30, 40, 10, 20. 3mm is 120. That's about right. So what I'm going to do now is slacken off this jaw at the back. And push this, tighten up this jaw so the clock is back to the original zero. 1, 2, 3. So tighten this back up till it comes to zero. That's near enough. This is in tenths of a thou, so that's near enough. We'll just make sure the others are locked. What I'll do is just turn a small diameter to see how it looks.
Okay.
screwed up their ass. 496. Steady that. So let's put this back on centre. So I need to push it now the opposite way to what I did before. So with the big diameter running true, and this diameter at its farthest out, I'm now going to push this diameter further out by another 2mm. I've already put 2mm on the clock, so if I set this, undo this, and push this over 1, 10, 20, 40. I need to bring it back up to zero. Tighten that back up. Just move my centering to see where the centre will be. I've got some offset, yeah, I've got about 4mm offset. My next job is to part this off. This is a 3mm tap. Let's just put a flat bottomed hole there just to give the milling cutter less work. When I did this in the past, I used a 3-jaw chuck, but because I'm on a 4-jaw chuck, I haven't got any reference points, so I'm having to use a chuck jaw and a 30 degree offset, so that would give me 120 degree turn to get the 3 points on the triangle. So that's 120, 120, 120, which is your 360. What I'm doing is putting the spirit level, which is set at 30, onto the chuck jaw, and here's the bubble in the level, which is level on that chuck jaw. I've got this in back gear, so the chuck is less likely to move. So I'm ready to cut the second flat. Thank you. turn it round 90 degrees. And get this lined up on the next chuck. Sure.
It's there.
Let's take this out, have a look.
Let me try and explain what I'm doing with the chuck jaws to get the triangle. These represent the chuck jaws. This is the job in the chuck. The first thing I did was set this jaw to zero and cut just below the centre line, a flat. Then the next thing you do is rotate it to the next jaw, which is 90 degrees, plus your 30 to get your 120. So you bring it to there with the spirit level on the jaw. Then you cut your next flat, which would be there. Now, because this jaw is already 30 off, to get back to the next jaw, it's 60 plus another 60 to get your third flat, which produces a triangle to hold the tungsten tip. To get the size bigger for the triangle, you lower the cutting tool in the tool post so that it drops further down and takes more off the flats, and you just repeat the process again, going round until you've cut the flats big enough to put the tip in.
Doing at the moment is just milling off the edges of this part that sticks out so that the tip of the cutter can get right in close.
That's the finished tool holder. That flat is the centre of the radius cutter, and then this can move in up to the centre, and you just put slip gauges or feeler gauges in there to set this size you need. Oh well, that's it for today. Hope this was useful, and hope to see you next time on Enots Engineering.